Can't believe it's been 2 years almost since I did a little video on this Orange Pi Zero 2, you know, and I didn't know it was going to be so popular, but you know, I'm back because I had been waiting for something that had gigabit Ethernet and USB 3, which this does not have.
I just wanted to interrupt my own intro, which sounds silly, but I'm aware that there are other USB 3 single board computers that have gigabit Ethernet, right? But like the Neo 3, for example. Sure, and of course the Raspberry Pis and Orange Pis, they have USB 3 and gigabit Ethernet, but they're not this small, and they're not this cheap. And even the Neo 3, I think it's like $40 or something. But the point is, something stood out about this one board. It's very small, and at the time was very affordable. But anyway, I'm gonna get back into the video.
And I saw it the other day on CNX software, and it's this. The Radxa Zero 3E. It's the Ethernet version. And I managed to get it at a good deal, $16. No shipping cost to me because it was Amazon, I guess a pre-order, or somebody made a mistake. It's not $16 anymore. but what is unique about this item, I mean, beyond just the fact that it's A55 instead of A53, has a pretty strong GPU, but the big thing is this, USB 3. That's a big deal. Gigabit Ethernet and USB 3, we're gonna put this through its paces. So I'm gonna go ahead and open this up, show you what it looks like inside, and we'll take a look, right? And it's only 1 gig version. It was most cost effective and it was only one available at the time, so I got that one instead. And to be honest, it's all I need. Because I proved in my other videos it's really all you need for most of the projects. I mean, this Zero 2, which has been replaced by Zero 3, you know, was able to run Jellyfin, so why not? So we're going to take it through its paces. And this also has a daughter board, or an add-on board, where you can get PoE, Power Over Ethernet. I kind of regret not getting that. But now everything is too expensive. Oh, again, we're going to take a look. Oh, nice. It's a nice hard case. Something the Orange Pi never came with. It came in like in a paper box. So far, it's pretty nice looking. Anti-static bag. Let's take a look. Oh, that's pretty high quality. That's very high quality. You can see that color coded. There's a ROC chip 3566, gig of RAM, pretty nice gig Ethernet. I don't know, I really wish they would release like these versions with only Ethernet without Wi-Fi, because most of the time the Wi-Fi on these are pretty awful and they don't really support access being access point. So yeah, microSD. So I'm not going to go over all the components on here, really, because I'm not going to be using them all. I won't be using the HDMI, probably ever. We'll see. Maybe it'll be a nice emulator. But I will be using the USB 3. We're putting that for those paces. In fact, I got all sorts of goodies here. Way to test how much power it uses, all sorts of splitters and hubs. I got myself a hub here, so I can definitely put some more stuff in. I also want to see if I can add another Ethernet to this. And because 2.5 gigabit should run on this USB 3 port, which should be 5 gigs. So this 2.5 gigabit Ethernet should be doable. So we'll see. We'll see if the kernels are good, because I've heard some stories. We're going to find, we're going to try out Armbian first, see if that boots. And I'll see you on the flip side. All right, got my USB tester here. And so we're gonna put this in. Armbian on the micro SD card. And let's see how much power it uses. Doesn't seem so horrible. We'll see how far it boots. Seems to be booting now. yeah, they're spiking up. So it's not really that bad. Maybe 600-700 milliamps. But I will be plugging in various devices and we'll see how it performs. See if it can handle, because supposedly this USB-C port only supports 500 milliamps. Hopefully it supports more than that. But we'll find out. But it seems to be pretty in line, so I'm going to check the Ethernet, check the network to see if this thing has shown up. Hopefully it has.
Okay, got it set up here. I'm going to do an iperf 3 test, but first we got to install iperf 3. And as you can see there down below, you can see there's a little some errors here and there from using Armbian. So that's why I ended up switching to the official build of Debian with XFCE. So we got iperf 3 set up. Set up the server on the Radxa. Then I'm going to connect from my computer. Of course, I put in the wrong IP address, so don't do what I did. Make sure you put in the right IP address. So we're going to go ahead and connect, and then you'll see the performance of the gigabit connection, the onboard gigabit connection. So it's able to saturate the line pretty well, so no issues there. What a surprise. It's the same we saw from 2 years ago from the Orange Pi 02, so that's fine.
All right, guys, I just wanted to add that I will be serving all the video files from this Samsung 1TB SSD, going from USB 3 to SATA adapter, right, into the port. I can't measure the power consumption because the ports are too close together, so I can't plug in the little meter to check it, but so far it's been running just fine, so I'm just letting you know this is the setup when I'm serving video files. So I'm going to go back to the test now.
Okay, I have Kodi set up here on my PC. It's connected to the Radxa, which is just running Nginx web server, serving files directly to Kodi, my personal computer here. So I have some test files set up. They're the famous Jellyfish test files that you can get. And I just jumped to 250 because I think that's where we left off on the Orange Pi Zero from last time. But as you can see here, the buffer is filling up very quickly at 250, which is a lot, which is, you know, completely dwarfs Blu-ray movies. Just to let you know, in terms of bit rate, 250 is a lot. So we'll jump to 300 megs. And it's able to serve the files just fine. That gigabit connection is really... it's really getting work out there. More than anything is the USB 3. The USB 3 connection gives us the ability to really watch these high bitrate files. And then we'll jump to the last one, which is 400 megabits per second. And you're going to see in just a moment that the combination of that USB 3 and the gigabit connection, it really takes it to the next level. And you see the buffer, no problem. There's no problem buffering. So I just wanted to let you guys see that. As a media server, not a problem at all. So that gives you an idea that you can have multiple videos streaming at the same time and you wouldn't saturate the line at all. It would be just fine. It would never fill. Everybody can be happy watching their movies, right? Okay, here we are. Jellyfin running through Docker. And yeah, I'm going to show you how it works. Seems to work fine. So I'm going to show you an example. I have some H.264, some HEVC H.265 files, a mix. So this first one's a TV show, H.264. Turn off the subtitles there. And we'll go into playback info. And you can see there it's H.264 AAC. So it's usually most browsers and devices will support this just fine. So, you know, no surprises there, right? And I'm going to show you also the consumption here. So we're not even using that much RAM. Of course, it's just streaming it directly, so there's really not any stress on the CPU or anything like that. So we have a movie example here, H.264. Again, no surprises. It's a 1080p movie, so it shouldn't be an issue at all in terms of streaming. And you can definitely skip around, no problems, right? So the next one is a show, H.265, or HEVC, however you wish to say that. This is a little more taxing because it has to change the container, I believe. It has to rearrange in some way so it can stream easier for us in the browser. But besides the point, it does work. HEVC, it does take up a little more CPU, a little more RAM, but it's slight. It's really slight. And once it gets going, it's fine. So no problems there. You can see there FFmpeg is doing its thing there. It works fine, right? Jellyfin works fine. And in order for it to work fine, though, you're going to have to change some settings, though. So make sure you go to your dashboard. Then you go to users. Go click on your user. Scroll down to where it says allow video playback that requires transcoding. Uncheck that. And that way it doesn't become an issue for the Radxa Zero 3. Make sure you press save. And that's it. And then from then on, it should work fine. Okay, so we have a Samba share test here. I'm connected to the Radxa Zero 3 from my desktop computer. I mapped the drive to it. And I have some video files we're going to copy over directly over to the Radxa. So here we go. So there we go. We're writing at 115, 14, 13 megabytes per second. That's a good speed for gigabit Ethernet, so that's great. And that means we're also using the USB3 port very well too. So no slowdowns, no bottlenecks really in that. Well, now the gigabit Ethernet is the bottleneck. Before, on the earlier test, the orange pie was the opposite. So let's send it back. So we're going to read from that, and it's actually a little bit slower, just like the last test with the orange pie 02 from 2 years ago. The reading, for whatever reason, is slower. But still, it's over 100 megabytes per second. That's 800 megabits, over 800 megabits. That's pretty fast. So there you go. I will say, caveat, make sure the drive is formatted in like EXT4, not NTFS. When I did NTFS, it was super slow, and that's probably because it's not a Linux file system, right? So do that instead. That would be my suggestion, EXT4 or something similar. Let's throw in a bonus test here on the video. I mean, it's been long enough, right? But let's end it with this. So managed to get the 2.5 gigabit Ethernet USB adapter working. It does go up to two and a half, almost 2.5, and then back down again. Not a surprise. It's a Realtek USB Ethernet adapter. It is running at 2.5 gigabit because Atul does confirm it here. It does say 2.5 gigabits per second, and ended up buying a 2.5 gigabit switch for this test. Probably never going to use it again, but hey, it is what it is. But it can do it. So I just wanted to show, if you use one of the Armbian images, it does show up, it does work. And surprising, right? Radxa Zero 3E. Hard to believe, right? This little thing did all of that. It's fine with having a 1 terabyte SSD on it. And the whole time, no heatsink. No, none. Never overheated. Sure, it got a little warm when I was trying to transcode files earlier until I unchecked the option there in Jellyfin. But, you know, once you do that, it's a champ. I'm surprised. The software is still young. Even there's some errors in Armbian. But, you know, I'm impressed. I'm really impressed. It's so small. And this is exactly what I was looking for all this time. And yeah, it can definitely saturate that gigabit line. And I would love to really benchmark that USB 3 port. So we'll see about that. But in a few tips for you guys, you're going to run Jellyfin. Make sure it's in Docker. You maybe use Portainer to help, to help you set it all up. But I still going to stick with my my Kodi setup. It's just so much easier. Nginx web server to Kodi is just, it's easy. It's just too easy. But hey, if you guys want a tutorial on running Jellyfin on here, let me know in the comments if you are interested. Other than that, I hope you enjoyed. And if you want to know anything else, just ask. And yeah, have a great one.